Comedy Association principal, take this opportunity to send our heartfelt condolences to the entire McErlean family, his son and daughter, Kieran and Donna, his brothers and sisters, Pat, Rosaline, Kathleen, Anne, Sally, Bridget, Veronica, Seamus, George, Richard and Danny. We are acutely aware of their loss at this sad time. I want to take a moment to talk about my memories of Henry. I first met Henry when we were both being held for Vermont in the crew in 1981. We were both young men, though Henry was older by a few years and already a seasoned Republican volunteer. In 1981, the year of the hunger strikes, Drummond Road Jail was packed by rafters with Republican prisoners. We were often held 4 days cell, and this led to a special type of camaraderie among POWs as POWs. As Henry once said to me, there's nowhere to hide or be on your own in here. So family events, births, deaths, marriages and children's birthdays were always shared events among us. For months we paced the yard. The plight of the hunger strikers dominated our discussions. Every day was like a month as the hunger strikers died. We followed intensely every initiative that would see the prisoners' 5 just demands granted. There was a sadness in the crew in 1981 as one by one the 10 hunger strikers died. And whilst there remained a steely determination to support our comrades in the hate blocks, I would be telling a lie if I said that our morale remained high at all times. We were young, we went through a full range of emotions, including fear and uncertainty as to what the near future held for us as POWs. It was in these low times that Henry shone as a comrade. He was always there with a listening ear and wise advice. Of course, there's nothing like a victory to raise morale. And when the M60 men and Pete Ryan successfully shot their way out of the crumb, euphoria temporarily punctured our sadness at the events in the hate blocks. As is often the way after a remand, and as we got on with our days, we lost contact with each other for many years. Everyone who knew Henry knew the waterworks was one of his favourite places, and he was often to be found running and cycling. He always took the time to stop and have a chat when we met. When a couple of years ago, the decision to set up our ex-prisoners association, Henry was to the fore of taking on the role of treasurer. He had a natural affinity with his fellow former POWs and wanted to see an ex-prisoner-centred prisoners group. At an early stage, it was decided that the group should be open to all former POWs, regardless of what particular Republican tradition we had come from. Henry fully supported this move, and we became the only ex-prisoner group in Belfast that included former IRA and NLA political prisoners. We are fiercely proud of that, and we will continue to develop along these lines. Our hearts are very heavy. We've lost a very, very dear friend and comrade. And as the turnout here tonight shows, that Henry was held in the highest esteem by the people of Ardoyne. So, folks, tomorrow we lay Henry to rest. Husband, brother, father, grandfather, friend, comrade, Ardonian and soldier of the Republic. Rest in peace, comrade. Thank you. Ask for a minute's silence in Henry's memory. Go on, Mary. thank you very much for coming tonight. That's the end of tonight's proceedings. There's going to be a few lanterns lit, and the candle's going to be lit for Henry on the memorial later. So, listen, tomorrow's going to be a very sad day for us all, but let's make sure the volunteer Henry McErlean gets it through our doings to the end of. Sure, I got you all.
Thank you. From rebel veins my life I drew. In rebel arms I lay. From rebel lips the lessons drew that led me day by day. And rocked to rest on a rebel breast, nursed on a rebel knee. There woke and grew, for weal or rue, a rebel heart in me. A rebel heart, a rebel heart, from taints of thraldom free. God prosper still, for good or ill, this rebel heart and me. I've read my country's checkered page, I've sang her deathless songs, I've learned her woes from age to age, I've burned to right the wrong. And when I saw that to alien law she never bent her knee, then prouder yet, for Ireland beats this rebel heart in me. A rebel heart, a rebel heart, from taint of thraldom free. God prosper still, for good or ill, this rebel heart.
I walk in silence by her tiny feet to take primroses where my father sleeps. And I think of her while I stand and weep. A young heart very dear, so deep. And in winter I'll be there when the fields are cold and bare, and I'll stand and share my life with you. And I'll take away the snow so young spring flowers can grow. In summer, sun and rain, I'm there with you. I'll leave you now, but I'll return to this peaceful place where no heart can burn. And when autumn leaves, they fall all around, I return once again. And I'll take away the snow so young spring flowers can grow. And in summer, sun and rain, I'm there with you.
When apples still grow in November, when blossoms still bloom on each tree, when leaves are still green in December, it's then that your land will be free. I wander her hills and valleys, and still through my sorrow I see a land that has never known freedom, only her rivers run free. I drink to the death of her manhood, those men who would rather have died than to live in the cold chains of bondage, to bring back their rights were denied. Where are you now? What burns where the flame used to be? Are you gone like the snows of last winter?
Rod, not again!
How fragrant the rose, but it's dying. How gentle but with silence. What good is a new climate's edge? What joy is in eyes that can see when there's sorrow in sunshine and flowers?
Reach, Baldy! Hurrah! Let's get the key!